In this module, we shall discuss the special production functions. Nature imposes technological constraints on firms. Only certain combination of inputs are feasible ways to produce a given amount of output, and the firm must limit itself to technological feasible production plans. The easiest way to describe feasible production plan is to list them. The set of all combinations of input and output that comprise a technological feasible way is called a production function. I repeat, is called a production function. The relation between input and output of a firm is known as production function. Production function is a purely technical relation which connects factor inputs and output. It shows the maximum amount of output that can be produced from any specified set of inputs given the existing technology. It is a flow concept, so production refers to units of output over a period of time. It refers to the relation between inputs and outputs of a firm. It is a flow concept, so production refers to units of output over a period of time. Cobb-Douglas production function. In economics, the Cobb-Douglas production function is widely used to represent the relationship between inputs and output in an economy. The two most important neoclassical production functions are the constant elasticity of substitution, CES, and the Cobb-Douglas. The Cobb-Douglas production function was created by Charles Cobb, mathematician, and Paul Douglas, economist, in 1927. But its functional form was proposed by Knut Wicksell, economist, in the 19th century. The Cobb-Douglas production function lies between linear and fixed proportion production function with elasticity of substitution equal to 1. It is very popular among economists because of its flexibility and ease of use. Next, we will discuss the mathematical form. The mathematical form of the Cobb-Douglas production function for a single output with two factors can be written as y is equal to function of k, L, and A is equal to A into K raised to the power alpha and L raised to power 1 minus alpha, where Y is equal to output, K is equal to capital input, L is equal to labor input, A is equal to level of technology or total factor productivity, where A is greater than 0, alpha constant between 0 and 1, where 0 is less than alpha, less than 1. Now we study returns to scale. The return to scale is a long run concept when all the factors of production are variable. In long run, output can be increased by increasing all the factor of production. An increase in scale means that all factors are increased in the same proportion. Output will increase, but the increase may be at an increasing rate or at a constant rate or at a decreasing rate. Let us now discuss the three situations of returns to the scale. First one is increasing returns to scale. Increasing return to scale occurs when output increases in a greater proportion than increase in inputs. If all factors are increased by 20%, then output increases by say 30%. So by doubling the factors, output increases by more than double. Constant returns to scale. constant return to scale occurs when output increases in the same proportion as increase in input. If all factors are increased by 20%, then output also increases by 20%. So, doubling of all factors causes a doubling of output, then returns to scale are constant. The constant return to scale is also called linearly homogeneous production function. Decreasing returns to scale. Decreasing return to scale occurs when output increases in a lesser proportion than increase in inputs. If all the factors are increased by 20%, then output increases by less than 20%. The Cobb-Douglas production function exhibits constant returns to scale. Constant returns to scale occurs when output increases in the same proportion as increase in input. Under constant returns to scale, the sum of two exponents for capital and labor is 1, that is, alpha plus 1 minus alpha is equal to 1. It is shown in the given figure. The labor and capital is shown on x-axis and y-axis respectively. Y1, Y2 and Y3 are the isoquant curves showing different levels of output. Under constant return to scale, the distance between successive isoquants remain same as we expand output from 100 to 200 to 300 units. On straight line OR starting from origin, the distance OA, AB and BC all are equal. If the sum of the two exponents for capital and labor is greater than 1, then the function exhibits increasing returns to scale. And if the sum of the two exponents for capital and labor is less than 1, then the function exhibits decreasing returns to scale. Isoquant are convex to the origin. Under Cobb-Douglas production function, isoquant are convex to the origin. Figure represents an isoquant map. An isoquant map refers to the family of isoquant curves where higher the isoquant, higher is the level of production. In the figure, labor is measured on x-axis and capital on y-axis. Y1, Y2 and Y3 are the isoquant curves showing various possible combinations of inputs physically capable of producing a given level of output. If you can operate production activities independently, then weighted averages of production plans will also be feasible. Hence, the isoquants will have a convex shape. The isoquant Y1 represents 100 units of output, whereas isoquant Y2 represents 200 units of output, and the level of output is higher on isoquant Y2 than Y1. Isoquant Y3 shows 300 units of output, which is higher than the level of output as shown by isoquant Y1 and Y2 and so on. So, higher the isoquant, higher is the level of output. We have seen that the isoquant are downward sloping, convex to the origin, diminishing MRTS, higher the isoquant, higher the level of output. We further study marginal products and average products. Under Cobb-Douglas production function, the average product and marginal products of factor depend upon the ratio in which the factors are combined to produce output. MPK is equal to delta Y upon delta K is equal to A into alpha into K raised to power alpha minus 1 into L raised to the power 1 minus alpha. which is equal to A into alpha K upon L raised to the power alpha minus 1. APK is equal to Y upon K, which is equal to A into K raised to the power alpha into L 1 minus alpha upon K, which is equal to A into K upon L raised to the power alpha minus 1. The average product of capital depends on the ratio of capital and labor K upon L and does not depend upon the absolute quantities of the factors used. The same is true for labor. The marginal product is proportional to the output per unit of its factor. MPK is equal to delta Y upon delta K equal to A into alpha into K raised to the power alpha minus 1 into L raised to the power 1 minus alpha equal to A into alpha K upon L raised to the power alpha minus 1 is equal to alpha into Y upon K. MPL is equal to delta Y upon delta L, which is equal to A 1 minus alpha into K raised to the power alpha into L raised to the power minus alpha, which is equal to A 1 minus alpha into K upon L raised to the power alpha is equal to 1 minus alpha into Y upon L. Linear in logarithm. The Cobb-Douglas production function is linear in logarithm. Let Y is a function of K, L, A, which is equal to A into K raised to the power alpha into L raised to the power 1 minus alpha. Now applying log both sides, we get log Y is equal to log A plus alpha log K plus 1 minus alpha log L, where alpha is the partial elasticity of output with respect to capital. It measures the percentage change in output for, say, 1% change in the capital input holding the labor input constant. 1 minus alpha is the partial elasticity of output with respect to labor. It measures the percentage change in output for, say, 1% change in the labor input holding the capital input constant. Properties of Cobb-Douglas production function. First, constant returns to scale. The Cobb-Douglas production function exhibits constant returns to scale. If the inputs, capital and labor are increased by a positive constant lambda, then output also increases by the same proportion, that is, function of lambda into K, lambda into L and A, which is equal to lambda into function of K, L and A. For all, lambda is greater than 0. Y is equal to function of K, L and A equal to A into K raised to the power alpha into L raised to the power 1 minus alpha. F is a function of lambda into K, lambda into L and A, which is equal to A into lambda K raised to the power alpha into lambda L raised to the power 1 minus alpha, which is equal to A lambda raised to the power alpha K raised to the power alpha lambda raised to the power 1 minus alpha L raised to the power 1 minus alpha, which is equal to lambda into A into K raised to the power alpha into L 1 minus alpha, which is equal to lambda into y. If the function exhibits decreasing returns to scale, then f is a function of lambda k, lambda l, and a less than lambda y for any lambda greater than 1. If the function exhibits increasing returns to scale, then f is a function of lambda k, lambda l, and a which is greater than lambda y for any lambda greater than 1. First, positive and diminishing returns to inputs. The Cobb-Douglas production function is increasing in labor and capital, that is positive marginal products. First, delta y upon delta k is greater than 0 and delta y upon delta l is greater than 0. Y is equal to function of k, l and a is equal to a k raised to the power alpha l raised to the power 1 minus alpha. MPK is equal to delta y upon delta k is equal to a alpha k raised to the power alpha minus 1 l raised to the power 1 minus alpha. MPL is equal to delta y upon delta l equal to a 1 minus alpha k raised to the power alpha l raised to the power minus alpha. Diminishing marginal products with respect to each input. Del square y upon del k square is less than 0. Del square y upon del l square is less than 0. Del square y upon del k square is equal to a into alpha minus 1 into k raised to the power alpha minus 2 into l raised to the power 1 minus alpha is less than 0 if alpha is less than 1. Here, any small increase in capital will lead to a decrease in the marginal product of capital. Any small increase in capital cause output to rise but at a diminishing rate. The same is true for labor. Second, INADA conditions. First, the marginal product of capital, labor approaches infinity as capital, labor goes to zero. Limit k tends to zero, delta y upon delta k is equal to limit l tends to 0, delta y upon delta l is equal to infinity. Second, the marginal product of capital, labor approaches 0 as capital, labor goes to infinity. Limit k tends to infinity, delta y upon delta k is equal to limit l tends to infinity, delta y upon delta l is equal to 0. The next property is that the Cobb-Douglas production function has elasticity of substitution equal to unity. Sigma is equal to differentiation k upon l upon differentiation mrts into mrts upon k upon l, where mrts is equal to mpl upon mpk. MRTS is equal to MPL upon MPK equal to a 1 minus alpha k raised to the power alpha L raised to the power minus alpha upon a alpha k raised to the power alpha minus 1 L raised to the power 1 minus alpha is equal to 1 minus alpha upon alpha into k upon L. K upon L is equal to alpha upon 1 minus alpha into MRTS. Differentiation K upon L upon differentiation MRTS is equal to alpha upon 1 minus alpha. Sigma is equal to differentiation K upon L upon differentiation MRTS into MRTS upon K upon L is equal to 1. Constant income shares of output. The exponent of capital labor alpha 1 minus alpha represents the contribution of capital labor to output. This is the same as the portion of output distributed to capital labor, that is capital labor income share. Y is equal to function of K, L and A is equal to A, K raised to the power alpha, L raised to the power 1 minus alpha. The real wage of labor W is calculated by partially differentiating Y with respect to L, which is nothing but marginal product of labor MPL. W is equal to MPL is equal to delta Y upon delta L is equal to A 1 minus alpha K raised to the power alpha L raised to the power minus alpha is equal to A 1 minus alpha K upon L raised to the power alpha is equal to 1 minus alpha Y upon L. Total wage bill is equal to W into L is equal to MPL into L is equal to A 1 minus alpha K raised to the power alpha L raised to the power 1 minus alpha. The labor share in real national product is total wage bill upon real national product is equal to total wage bill upon real national product is equal to WL upon Y equal to A 1 minus alpha K raised to the power alpha L raised to the power 1 minus alpha upon A K raised to the power alpha L raised to the power 1 minus alpha is equal to 1 minus alpha. In the same way, the capital income share remains constant at alpha. Another most popular neoclassical production function is constant elasticity of substitution CES production function. The CES production function was developed by Arrow, Chinnery, Minhas and Solow as a generalization of the Cobb-Douglas production function that allows for non-negative and constant elasticity of substitution. The standard CES production function can be written as Y is equal to A delta into K raised to the power minus rho plus 1 minus delta into L raised to the power minus rho whole raised to the power minus 1 upon rho, where Y is output, K and L are capital and labor inputs and A, delta, rho are the parameters. A, technology determines the productivity and A belongs to 0 and infinity. Delta determines the optimal distribution of inputs and delta belongs to 0 and 1. Rho determines the elasticity of substitution where rho belongs to minus 1 and 0 union 0 and infinity and sigma is equal to 1 upon 1 plus rho. Special cases under CES production function. First, for rho tends to 0, sigma approaches 1. Cobb-Douglas production function. Second, for rho tends to positive infinity, sigma approaches 0, Leontief production function. Third, for rho tends to minus 1, sigma approaches infinity, perfect substitutes. The CES production function is linearly homogeneous and therefore exhibits constant returns to scale. It is non-linear in parameters so cannot be estimated using least squares method. First, constant returns to scale. The Cobb-Douglas production function exhibits constant returns to scale. Y is equal to A delta K raised to the power minus rho plus 1 minus delta into L raised to the power minus rho whole raised to the power minus 1 upon rho. F is a function of lambda K, lambda L. A is equal to A delta lambda K raised to the power minus rho plus 1 minus delta lambda L raised to the power minus rho whole raised to the power minus 1 upon rho is equal to A lambda delta K raised to the power minus rho plus 1 minus delta L raised to the power minus rho whole raised to the power minus 1 upon rho is equal to lambda y. Second property is positive and diminishing returns to input. The marginal products of the input are MPK is equal to delta y upon delta k is equal to delta upon A raised to the power rho into y upon k raised to the power rho plus 1. MPL is equal to delta y upon delta L is equal to 1 minus delta upon A raised to the power rho into y upon L raised to the power rho plus 1. They both are positive for K L greater than 0. With any small increase in capital or labor increases the output, but at a diminishing rate. In ADA conditions, first, the marginal product of capital labor approaches infinity as capital labor goes to 0. Limit K tends to 0, delta Y upon delta K is equal to limit L tends to 0, delta Y upon delta L is equal to infinity. Second, the marginal product of capital labor approaches 0 as capital labor goes to infinity. Limit K tends to infinity, delta Y upon delta K is equal to limit L tends to infinity, delta Y upon delta L is equal to 0. The elasticity of substitution is sigma is equal to 1 upon 1 plus rho. The elasticity of substitution is calculated using formula sigma is equal to differentiation of K upon L upon differentiation of MRTS into MRTS upon K upon L, where MRTS is equal to MPL upon MPK. MRTS is equal to MPL upon MPK equal to 1 minus delta upon delta into K upon L raised to the power rho plus 1. Differentiation MRTS upon differentiation K upon L is equal to 1 minus delta upon delta into K upon L raised to the power rho into 1 plus rho. Sigma is equal to differentiation K upon L upon differentiation MRTX into MRTX upon K upon L is equal to 1 upon 1 plus rho. Earlier we have discussed about CES production function. Once we relax the assumption of constant elasticity of substitution, we arrive at variable elasticity of substitution VES. The VES production function can be expressed as Y is equal to gamma K raised to the power alpha into 1 minus delta rho into L plus rho minus 1 into K raised to the power alpha delta rho, where Y is equal to output, K is equal to capital, L is equal to labor. Alpha, rho, delta and gamma are parameters. Gamma is greater than 0, alpha greater than 0. Delta is greater than 0, less than 1. Rho into delta is greater and equal to 0 and less than or equal to 1. L upon K is greater than 1 minus rho upon 1 minus rho into delta. Here, alpha is the parameter of returns of scale. If the value of alpha is 1, the production function exhibits constant returns to scale. Elasticity of substitution. The elasticity of substitution sigma for the VES production function is sigma is equal to sigma KL is equal to 1 plus rho minus 1 upon 1 minus delta rho into K upon L. The elasticity of substitution sigma varies with the capital labor ratio around the intercept term of unity. The elasticity of substitution is greater than 0 over the relevant range of K upon L. For sigma is greater than 0 requires that L upon K is greater than 1 minus rho upon 1 minus delta into rho. Let us now study the properties of VES production function. First is positive and diminishing returns to inputs. The VES production function is increasing in labor and capital, that is positive marginal products. Second, delta Y upon delta K is greater than 0 and delta Y upon delta L is greater than 0. Y is equal to gamma K raised to the power alpha 1 minus delta rho into L plus rho minus 1 K whole raised to alpha delta rho. MPL is equal to delta Y upon delta L is equal to alpha delta rho Y upon L plus rho minus 1 into K is greater than 0 for delta rho is greater or equal to 0 less than equal to 1 and L upon K is greater than 1 minus rho upon 1 minus delta rho. MPK is equal to delta Y upon delta K is equal to alpha 1 minus delta rho into Y upon K plus alpha into delta into rho minus 1 Y upon L plus rho minus 1 into K is greater than 0. Here, any small increase in capital will lead to a decrease in the marginal product of capital. Any small increase in capital causes output to rise but at a diminishing rate. The same is true for labor. VES production function reduced to Cobb-Douglas and linear production function. For rho is equal to 0, Harrod-Domer fixed coefficient model. For rho equal to 1, Cobb-Douglas production function. For rho is equal to 1 upon delta greater than 1, linear production function. The elasticity of substitution can vary along an isoquant. The VES requires that the elasticity of substitution be the same only along a ray through the origin. The translog production function can be expressed as y is a function of x1, x2 till xn is equal to alpha 0 product of I is equal to 1 till n xi raised to the power ai. Product of I is equal to 1 till n xi raised to the power half sigma j is equal to 1 till n beta ij log of xj, where y is equal to output, alpha 0 is equal to efficiency parameter, alpha I and beta ij parameters unknown, xj input j. Logarithm form. taking log both sides, we obtain log y is equal to log alpha 0 plus summation of I is equal to 1 till n alpha I log of xi plus half summation of I is equal to 1 till n summation of j is equal to 1 till n beta ij log of xi log of xj. The translog production function is a generalization of the Cobb-Douglas production function. For beta ij is equal to 0, the log form of translog function reduces to a Cobb-Douglas production function. It is linear in parameters, so can be estimated using least squares method. Monotonicity and translog production function. The marginal product, that is addition to total product due to addition of one more factor, is MPI is equal to delta y upon delta xi is equal to delta into log y upon delta log xi into y upon xi, where delta into log y upon delta into log xi is the production elasticity, which can be calculated from log form. Delta into log y upon delta into log xi is equal to alpha I plus summation j is equal to 1 till n beta ij log xj, where I is equal to 1 to till n. So MPI is equal to alpha I plus summation j is equal to 1 till n beta ij log of xj into y upon xi. Next, we will examine whether isoquants under translog function convex. The isoquants are strictly quasi-convex if the bordered Hessian matrix is negative definite. In order to construct bordered Hessian matrix, we need to derive second direct and cross partial derivatives using chain rule. Fii is equal to delta square y upon delta k square is equal to y upon xi square beta ii plus alpha I plus summation j is equal to 1 till n beta ij log of xj minus 1 into alpha I plus summation j is equal to 1 till n beta ij log of xj. Fij is equal to delta square y upon delta into xy into delta into xj is equal to y upon xi into xj into beta ij plus alpha I plus summation j is equal to 1 till n beta ij log of xj into alpha j plus summation I is equal to 1 till n beta ij log of xi. The bordered Hessian matrix is shown here. The values of the first and second partial derivatives vary with input levels. There is no guarantee that the isoquants are globally convex. Let us now summarize what we have learned in this module. Production function is a purely technical relation which connects factor inputs and output. It shows the maximum amount of output that can be produced from any specified set of inputs given the existing technology. It is a flow concept, so production refers to units of output over a period of time. Cobb-Douglas production function is widely used to represent the relationship between input and output in an economy. The two most important new classical production functions are the constant elasticity of substitution, CES, and the Cobb-Douglas. The CES production function was developed by Arrow, Chinnery, Minhas, and Solow as a generalization of the Cobb-Douglas production function that allows for non-negative and constant elasticity of substitution. The CES production function is
linearly homogeneous and therefore exhibits constant returns to scale. It is non-linear in parameters, so cannot be estimated using least squares method.